Es ergo cogita. Cogitas ergo dubita. You are, therefore think. You think, therefore doubt. Time, whisper of eternity. Listen closely. Before the stars came to be, before the first light ignited, before the question, who are we, even arose, there was something that was neither darkness nor light, neither beginning nor end. Perhaps it was time, or perhaps something even more primal. Today, we will dive into that mystery, into something that fills every second of your existence, though you never truly see it. Something you can feel, like sensing the breath of the universe, yet never touch. Time, the most elusive of all energies. Philosophers have tried to define it for millennia. Some said it is a river in which you never step into the same water twice. Others, that it is merely the shadow of eternity dancing upon the wall of a cosmic cave. Still others believe that time does not exist until you ask about it. Saint Augustine, lost in thought, confessed, "I know what time is until someone asks me." And Nietzsche? He saw time as a circle, an infinite return of all that was and all that will be. But these are only words, fragments of attempts to explain what continually slips from the mind. For when you try to grasp time, it chuckles softly and slides through your fingers. It is like mist on the edge of a dream. The harder you try to hold it, the faster it vanishes. And yet, time touches everything. It burns stars. It bends light. It turns children into elders and galaxies into dust. It is the invisible mechanism that governs every change in the universe. But does it truly exist? When science entered the stage, it offered answers that only deepened the mystery. Newton said that time flows unwavering and indifferent, like a perfect clock that knows no pause. But Einstein tore that vision to shreds. He proved that time bends, twists, stretches, and contracts. The faster you move, the slower it flows. Near massive bodies, it can nearly halt. At the event horizon of a black hole, time may die. And now, listen to something even more unsettling. In the quantum realm, time may not exist at all. It neither flows, runs, nor jumps. It is only a web of relations between events, as if the universe plays music but forgot to write down the notes. Carlo Rovelli says that if you observe the world at a small enough scale, time evaporates. It dissolves. It disappears like a shadow in the mist. So, what is it? Energy? Illusion? A construct of the mind? Or perhaps a gateway to something we cannot yet name? Consider this. Every second of your life is like a spark flashing in darkness. It appears, illuminates a moment, and vanishes forever. But does it truly vanish? Or is it etched somewhere in the deep memory of the universe, like a ripple upon the surface of a calm ocean? Some physicists say the past still exists, that the future already exists, that only we move through time, like travelers who cannot comprehend the path they walk. Others claim time is merely a dimension, and our lives are lines drawn across a four-dimensional space, that nothing passes and everything simply is. Or perhaps time is just a byproduct of our own existence. Maybe it is born only when you open your eyes in the morning and vanishes when you fall asleep, where there is no yesterday, no tomorrow, no duration. Philosophers have asked, does time exist beyond humans? Science answers, we do not know. Perhaps it is not about finding answers, but about daring to ask at all. For the universe does not offer ready answers. It poses questions, sometimes whispered, sometimes hidden beneath billions of light years. When you gaze at the night sky, each star you see shows a different time. Some appear as they were 100 years ago, others 1,000, others still millions. You do not look at space, you look at the history of light. You look at the past. You look along a time bent into the shape of the heavens. Or maybe the universe has no beginning at all. Maybe time did not start with the Big Bang. Maybe it is only another chapter in a book with no first page. Perhaps the universe is infinite, eternal, and time is merely a wave carrying us across one of its oceans. If so, what are we? Are we a fleeting moment soon to vanish? Or a part of something enduring beyond epochs? Does time shape us, or do we shape time? Now, ask yourself this. If time does not exist as we think, what is your life? Could it be a story unfolding beyond time? Are your feelings, decisions, desires merely moments, or traces etched into a space larger than we can comprehend? Perhaps time is just the language of the universe. A code written in the motion of stars, in the cycles of galaxies, in the pulse of atoms. Perhaps time is the breath of God. Or perhaps there is no God, and then time itself is the only deity. Perhaps we are a journey, perhaps a story, perhaps a spark. Or perhaps eternity pretending to be a moment.
Time is a mystery we have tried to grasp since our first gaze at the sky. And though we seem to know more of it, the deeper we peer, the more it vanishes. As if the universe whispers, do not seek the end, do not seek the beginning, seek the seeking itself. And perhaps that is why you are here, because you doubt, because you ask, because you sense that it all has meaning, perhaps hidden, perhaps distant, but still real. And as long as you ask, as long as you seek, time, the universe, and you exist. Imagine standing in the midst of a vast expanse where everything pulses with the silent rhythm of existence. Things arise and fade. Stars are born and die. Worlds unfold their stories. Yet none of it would matter without a subtle observer, consciousness. It is consciousness that defines what we call time. Time is not a river flowing independently of us. It is not a cosmic clock ticking somewhere beyond reach. Time is far more intimate. It is the way consciousness organizes change. Without consciousness, there would be only events, changes, motion, energy. But no one would call one before and another after. There would be no before or after. Just as lines of latitude and longitude have no meaning without a globe. Consciousness allows us to see direction, an arrow, a sequence. When we observe the world, the mind does something extraordinary. It arranges what we see into a line, the line we call time. It gathers memories, labeling them as the past. It forms expectations, naming them the future, and leaves the space between, the fleeting instant we try to grasp, as the now. Time is a map, and consciousness is the point moving across it. Space locates matter. Time locates the observer. Now consider, what happens to time when consciousness vanishes? When we fall into dreamless sleep, lose awareness, or drift under anesthesia, hours may pass, and yet for us, nothing elapses. It is not time that ceases, it is time's meaning that dissolves. This inner experiment leads to one conclusion. Time exists only when someone experiences it. A star's light may travel billions of years, but if no one observes it, its journey has no length, only the movement of photons. Time emerges only when consciousness witnesses change. Philosophers intuited this for centuries. Kant said, time is not a feature of the world, but of our mind. Bergson claimed, real time is lived experience, not measurement. Einstein, in declaring time relative, unknowingly touched something spiritual. Time is the relation between event and observer. This is why we say time marks the position of consciousness in space. For wherever you are now, in your now, the entire universe, all its history, and all its potential converge. The now is the point from which waves of meaning radiate. And what if there were no consciousness? Would time exist at all? Without a mind perceiving change, the world would become an infinite, undifferentiated sequence of events, directionless. Phenomena would still occur, but nothing would form a story. Thus we say, time is the shadow cast by consciousness. Where an observer appears, a path emerges, a rhythm, a before and after. Where no one watches, there is no logical place for time. Perhaps time is not a universal law, but the product of awareness.
Perhaps it is merely a tool that life invented to understand the universe's flux. Or perhaps consciousness itself is the truest axis of time. For the universe persists, changes persist, but time, the time we know, begins only when humans awaken. I am universe, your universe.